Hey guys, it's your girl Shannon. So hopefully you are enjoying this beautiful day. I know I certainly am. So listen, I know that you guys have goals for home ownership, right? And in this crazy market, home ownership is still very possible. So get with your trusted professional. They can guide you through the process. But I want to go over that process really quickly with you right now. Just some basic steps that you need to be able to purchase your home. So most people start out with their search online. And so they'll do their research just to see, okay, steps to purchasing a home. What do I need to do? Or maybe they'll just start looking at homes. So by the time they get to me, they are a little somewhat educated, but I treat everyone as if they are totally new to this and they've never done any research, because I want to dispel some of those myths. And then I welcome questions as well. Okay, most people, I usually ask, okay, are you working with anyone? Have you spoken with a lender yet? Have you been pre-qualified? And usually the answer is no, which is totally fine. So once I go through all of my pre-qualifying questions, I will get them over to a couple of my preferred lenders, right? And so you are going to need that pre-approval first before you get started on searching for a home, because one, we want to know what type of budget we're working with. So the lender is going to ask, they're going to ask certain questions. They're going to want to look at your work history. They're going to want to look at history, you know, based on how you paid your bills. So they're going to want to look at your whole financial history just to see if you qualify, what your credit score is like, things like that. Also, you want to make sure that you have your credit together. So if you know that you've got some outstanding debt out there, just pay it off. Oftentimes, if it's really old debt or if it's debt that you know you're not sure about, I always refer my client to the lender, because see, the lender can take a look at your file, at your credit profile, and at your mortgage file, and determine, okay, this is what's holding you back. You need to pay this off, or, you know, reach out to this company and make payment arrangements. So, but if you know you have some issues, just take care of the issues. Also, we want to know, how much money do you have saved? Do you have money saved for a down payment? Do you have money saved for your closing costs? Because it's like this. If you have your credit score is a little questionable, then it can affect your pre-approval amount, right? So oftentimes, if you have a lower credit score, your interest rates are going to be a little bit higher, which is going to affect your pre-approval amount. So everything works hand in hand. So once the lender, they're going to take a look at your file, take a look to see if you are mortgage ready. We'll take a look and see if, you know, what you have saved up, all that good stuff. Once they take a look at that, then you'll get what's called a pre-approval letter, right? And so with that pre-approval letter, that gives me a guide. So if your budget is $400,000, we know we don't want to look in at homes that are $600,000, okay? Because you're not approved for that. So once we get your pre-approval amount, you and I, or whoever you're working with, you and your trusted professional, you guys will get together and you will go over that pre-approval amount. You'll take a look at some areas that you're interested in, go over that wish list, some things that you're looking for in a home, and then you will go shopping with your agent. So that's usually with my clients, we do what's called another full-fledged consultation, even after the initial consultation, because the initial consultation is just, like I said, some preliminary questions, and then I want to get you over to my lender. If for whatever reason the lender does not issue you a pre-approval, then most of my lenders, well, not most of them, all of them will put you on a plan to get you mortgage ready. So don't feel like, okay, Shannon, I've got some things that I need to work on. You're never going to work with me. That's not true. So we'll put you on a plan and follow up with you. But say, for instance, we can move forward and we've gone through the consultation. We have selected the area that you want. Now we're ready to shop. So we will go shopping for homes. And I always tell buyers, make sure you keep an open mind when you are shopping, because if you can get 2 out of 3 things on your wish list, you are certainly winning. Okay, so that's another thing. When you and I are together, or when you and your trusted professional, when you guys are together, let them know exactly what you're looking for in a home. If you only want your home to be 15 minutes from your job, that's fine. If you're close to a certain park, if you want to be close to a certain park, let your agent know. So that way your agent can tailor your search based on what you want, based on what your needs are and where you want to live. So we're shopping. You found the home that you like. We put in an offer, right? So in this crazy market, yes, offers are still getting accepted. People are buying and selling every day. But say, for instance, your offer gets accepted. So once it gets accepted, we are under contract, and that's when we start the negotiation. So you will get your home inspected. Home inspection, it's not something that is required, but it is highly recommended. You do not want to not get an inspection, because that inspection is basically like an orientation of your home. So it's going to let you know how all of the systems work, all that good stuff, right? How old the systems are, what goes here, which light switch turns that light on. So you definitely want an orientation. Those are highly recommended. So you get your inspection, and the inspection, say for instance, there are some things that, you know, you just can't live with, you're not comfortable with living with. So then possibly we are asking for some repairs to be done. And the seller does not have to complete those repairs. You, the buyer, if you are not comfortable with, you know, moving forward with, if we did ask for repairs and repairs are complete, you don't have to move forward. Okay. So say for instance, the house doesn't need any repairs, and we decide, you say, you know what, Shannon, I really like this. Let's just move forward. That's good. So in the background, your loan officer is going to start asking you for documents. The closing attorney, in Georgia, we use a closing attorney for all our closings. The closing attorney is going to reach out and get some background information on you. The lender is going to, you know, maybe collect some more documents from you if they haven't gotten those up front. Most of the lenders that I work with, they get all those documents up front. And so on the back end, it's just some, you know, maybe, you know, a document was missing, whatever. But pretty thorough. So once we make it past, you know, the inspection part, we've made it past a few negotiations, you have to get the property appraised if you're seeking financing. Now, I know you've been hearing about, you know, properties not appraising, people losing out, but the appraisal portion is still a part of the process. And so what that is, that lender is trying to make sure, no, they are making sure that the money that they are loaning you for that house, that house is worth the money that they are loaning you. So you have to have an appraisal. Now, if the house doesn't appraise, we've got some other negotiation tactics that we can use, and that's, we'll address that as it comes. But you get an appraise, say for instance, the house does appraise and everything's good to go. We have our final walkthrough, and in our final walkthrough, we're just making sure that if we had to ask for repairs, that those repairs are done. We're verifying that if the home was occupied, that it's no longer occupied and that the seller's gotten all of their things out. And we also want to make sure that that home is in that same condition that it was in when we put it under contract. So that's our walkthrough. And once we do our walkthrough and all parties are satisfied, we meet at the closing table, you sign your documents, and you get your keys to your new home. So that is pretty much purchasing a home in a nutshell. It's certainly not all inclusive, and as situations arise, we address them, but that is really, it's an emotional process and it can be complicated. So you want to make sure that your trusted professional is there to guide you through the whole process. I hope this helps. You know, if you have any questions, you can always reach out. I'll talk to you guys soon.